Hello and welcome to the Daily Vision Bible. I'm Robbie Yates, and my wife, in her infinite wisdom, has decided that we needed a new bed. And so after several hours putting it together, this is where I'm recording from. Personally, I prefer the old one, but who am I to argue with a woman? Reading Deuteronomy chapter 17 today, let's open God's word to a prayer. Lord, I ask that as I read your word, they reveal something new to me. I also ask that as people hear your word, they come to better understanding of you. Amen. You shall not sacrifice to Yahweh your God an ox or sheep in which is a defect or anything evil, for that's an abomination to Yahweh your God. If there is found among you, within any of your gates which Yahweh your God gives you, a man or woman who does that which is evil in Yahweh your God's sight, in transgressing his covenant, and has gone and served other gods, and worshipped them, or the sun, or the moon, or any of the stars of the sky, which I have not commanded, and you are told, and you have heard of it, then you shall inquire with caution. If you find it to be true, and the thing certain, that such abomination is done in Israel, then you shall bring out that man or that woman, who has done this evil thing to your gates, even that same man or woman, and you shall stone him to death with stones. And a man for two witnesses, or three witnesses, he who is to die shall be put to death, and a man for one witness, he shall not be put to death. The hand of the witness shall be first on him to put him to death, and afterward the hand of all the people. So he shall remove the evil thing from among you. If there arises a matter too hard for you in judgment, between blood and blood, between plea and plea, and between stroke and stroke, being matters of controversy within your gates, then you shall arise and go up to the place which Yahweh your God chooses. You shall come to the priests or Levites, and to the judge you shall be in those days. You shall inquire, and they shall give you the verdict. You shall do according to the decision of the verdict, which they shall give you from that place which Yahweh chooses. You shall observe to do according to all that they shall teach you, according to the decisions of the law, which they shall teach you, and according to the judgment which they shall tell you, you shall do. You shall not turn aside from the sentence which they shall show you, to the right hand nor to the left. The man who acts rashly, and not listening to the priest who stands to minister there before Yahweh your God, unto the judge, even that man shall die. You shall put away the evil from Israel. All the people shall hear and fear and do nothing rashly. When you have come into the land which Yahweh your God gives you and possess it and dwell in it, and say, I will set a king over me, like all the nations that are around me, you shall surely set him king over yourselves, whom Yahweh your God chooses. You shall set as king over you one from among your brothers. You may not put a foreigner over you, who is not your brother. Only he shall not multiply horses to himself, nor cause the people to return to Egypt, to the end that he may multiply horses, because Yahweh said to you, you shall not go back that way again. He shall not multiply wives to himself, so that his heart not turn away. He shall not greatly multiply to himself silver and gold. It shall be, when he sits on the throne of his kingdom, that he shall write himself a copy of this law in a book, out of that which is before the priests of the Levites. It shall be with him, and he shall read from it all the days of his life, that he may learn to fear Yahweh his God, to keep all the words of this law and these commands, to do them, so that his heart not be lifted up above his brothers, and that he not turn aside from the commandment, to the right hand, to the left, to the end that he may prolong his days in his kingdom, he and his children, in the middle of Israel.